My name's Paul Roberts. I'm a technical specialist at Microsoft. This is a short video that looks at the event timeline within the Defender for IoT platform. This is a follow-on to the alerts section, where hopefully you've learnt about what the alerts mean and how they're handled. Now, the alerts can be considered as a call to action that the platform will generate, which means something has happened on the network that requires attention. The event timeline is another tool on the platform that allows you to investigate what happened around that alert. The easiest way to get into the timeline is by clicking the link on the left-hand side. This takes us into the event timeline and shows us everything that the platform considers worthy of investigation or to help you investigate those alerts. There are three types of events on the platform. There is an alert, a notice, and information. So the alerts will appear in the event timeline to allow you to track back and understand what happened leading up to that. But there are also, like I said, notices on the platform, so things like PLC programming, and information alerts around things like PLC configuration reads and authentication. We've got some various options across the top. So the first is a free search field. And if we start typing in that free search field, it will give us the options as an autocomplete. So in this case, I can search for any event that includes Ethernet IP or is related to Ethernet IP. So in this case, we can see that there's a PLC configuration read. We've got an alert generated around an invalid request. We've got PLC programming, configuration reads, etc. To clear it, we just click on the X, click the search button, and it goes back to the default event timeline view. We can also add in additional filters. So we can pick specific devices to be included. We can exclude specific devices. We can include event types, exclude event types, and focus just on specific device groups as well. We can then change the view to include alerts only, or alerts and notices, or all events. So all events will obviously include the information events as well. We can look at specific user operations. So these are events where a user has taken an action. And that could be, as you can see here, a user logging into the platform, or it could be a user performing PLC programming, authentication, PLC configuration reads, firmware updates, etc. By clicking it again, it clears that filter. And we can also search based on a specific date. So if you know something happened 3 or 4 days ago, we can select that date and it will show us events up to that point. Then obviously, as the platform is listening to the network traffic, additional events may be created. So we have the refresh option. We can create an event to provide a point of reference within the timeline, and we can export these events also out to a CSV file. So this is showing the complete event timeline. But I can also go into my device map. I can pick a specific asset. So in this case, I'm going to pick a PLC, and I can look at the events that relate only to that PLC. So now you can see I've got all the events as they relate only to that device. What I can also do through the alert section is I can pick a specific alert. So in this case, I've got NotPetya malware, and I can click on the event timeline button here, and that will put that alert at the top of my timeline. So now I can track back to understand exactly what happened prior to this alert being generated. So down here, for example, I can see that those devices or that device has communicated with the internet prior to the malware notification. So it gives me a pretty good idea that that device connected to the internet was either subject to a drive-by download or potentially a phishing attack. We'd need to do some more investigation to discover exactly what happened. But it's pretty safe to assume that that device was infected thanks to it being able to connect to the internet. Hope you found this useful. The additional tools will be explained in other sections. But thank you very much for listening.